lovely, beautiful Libra friends, and welcome to your horoscope for November of 2020. We're Libra this month. We've got planets coming out of retrograde, so the retrograde activity is decreasing, which means that activity and energy moving forward is increasing. So it's a beautiful month for that. We've got Mercury coming out of retrograde, Mars coming out of retrograde, Neptune coming out of retrograde. We've got a new moon that happens to be a super moon, a lunar eclipse happening this month, and the last of the Jupiter-Pluto conjunction. So it is a movable month happening for sure. Now, before we jump in and talk about what's going on for you this month, remember that the eat and greets are happening, and you can watch the eat and greets in the playback absolutely ad-free by joining me over on Patreon, and it is so very, very worth it for all parties involved. So this month, I am so pumped to be bringing you Judith Hill, Matthew Wiemet will be here, Omari Martin, Demetrius Bagley, Mecca Woods, Vanessa Montgomery will be here. I mean, it is just such a loaded month of people coming to visit. Jezebel will be here. So if you haven't had the opportunity to sit and study and hear the perspective of these beautiful astrologers, I'm pumped to put them right in front of you. So I will see you at the eat and greets, okay? All right, let's talk about what's going on this month, Libra. Right as we come into the month on the 3rd, we've got Mercury coming out of retrograde in your sign. Now, Mercury traveled through your sign, got out of your sign, then came back through Scorpio, back into your sign. So as Mercury is direct here, first of all, just some general rules. When Mercury's out of retrograde, then we're much more able to communicate freely, communicate in a way that is clear of distractions, misunderstandings, all of those things. But also, it has been a really good, I think, time while Mercury was retrograde for you to relook at your communication in your relationships, how you are communicating, information you are putting out there in your business relationships, your personal relationships. How is Libra showing up? Also, in how you would like to be seen. We don't often think of Mercury as this very visible, you know, how I'm seen kind of energy, but I think that in the way that you communicate, and that comes down to even your clothing, Libra, how are you showing up? How are you presenting yourself? We have been in the house for a very long time. Are you remembering to brush your teeth, do your hair, you know, bring it up a little bit. The energies are ready to move forward, so let's move forward with it. Make sure you're showing up as your best self to the very best of your ability, of course. Now, when we get to the 10th of the month, we see Mercury not only out of retrograde, but also moving forward now back into that energy of Scorpio, which is going to light up your second house space just right next door here. So as Mercury's here in Scorpio, again, you have already done an evaluation, a look at and an evaluation of this area. And now in your finances, in your self-esteem, you've had an opportunity to really observe your passions, observe your emotions, observe your thinking in this particular area of your life. So as Mercury is out of retrograde here, you can be a lot more assertive. You can take a deeper dive into what you're doing in the area of your finances and your self-esteem. Now, I do think too, Mercury being a very business savvy, this could definitely have contracts or business that comes to you. You're a very social energy. So it could be that you're having conversations and that actually leads to income, or that leads to opportunities for income in your life. The last question I'll ask you, Libra, is because you've had so much fourth house stuff going on, or things with the family, you know, is this a space of, have you thought about passive income? Have you thought about IRAs, any of these kinds of things that will allow money or finances or things of value to continue to come to you if another source is shut off? So make sure you're considering that as well, okay? On the 12th, we've got Jupiter-Pluto coming together in conjunction in the energy of Capricorn. Now, we have seen this 3 different times this year. We saw it in April, we saw it again in June, and now we're seeing it here as we close out this year. And the path and the pattern of that was that as they came together in April, we began something here. They were both direct. It's like the Sonic Hedgehog energy. As they come together, you realize that you have this dream, you have this passion, you have this desire, you start, you begin something, and it's like, and you're really able to kind of get after it. When it showed up again in June, they were both in retrograde, so you were reviewing that. And between April and June, and then June and now, you were building a lot of speed, heat, and stamina, and patient, persistent to change into what we will find you being as we're here in November. So you reevaluated in June. So I ask you, what did you start in the area of your home zone, your emotional security, an actual move in your house? Did something change with your parents? Because as Jupiter and Pluto come back together now on the 12th, you realize you have an inner resource that I don't think you really knew that you had at the beginning of the year. It was more of a desire there. Now it's, I have this inner resource, I can meet these challenges and I can really be successful in this area. So whatever that is, this Jupiter Pluto conjunction is like, we can do it. You know, it's kind of your best cheerleader for the month in that particular area. On the 14th, we see Mars coming out of retrograde in the energy of Aries, which is just across the street. So that lights up the seventh house space for you. Conscious chosen relationships, conscious chosen one-on-one relationships to include the space of your open enemies, which means you know that you have an issue with this person. As Mars was in retrograde, it was asking us in the area of your relationships to relook at your strategy. How are you going about your relationships? It was also asking you, do you still have the desire to be in fill in the blank relationship? What's your desire? Mars is our planet of desire. Saturn is actually the one that helps us get it done and stick to it and finish it out. But Mars is the desire. Do you have the desire to be in this relationship anymore? Are you guys on the same page? You know, what's your strategy if you do want to stay in your relationships, to keep them healthy, to keep them active, to keep them moving? Where is your identity within your relationships, your autonomy? So all of those things were asked as Mars was retrograde. And now that he's out of retrograde, you have to start really, you know, walking that new identity out, walking that new strategy out in this area of your life. And it's assertively, not aggressively, right? Assertively being in your own autonomy in your relationships, assertively saying, you know what, I've thought about it, I've prayed about it, this is not working out for us, or I thought about it, I prayed about it, like to be your partner, you know, whatever that looks like. There's this assertive, now Mars is ready to go piece of your identity that's taken on in your relationships. And even if you did have a challenge, a legal battle, something like that going on, you're being asked as Mars is out of retrograde to step up assertively, not aggressively, but go get it. Go after what needs to happen in that area. On the 15th, we've got the new moon happening in the energy of Scorpio, which happens to be a super moon because it's pretty close to the Earth. So we'll feel those, you know, we'll feel the impact of that. That again is going to be over in your second house. And then very quickly, we have Venus, your ruling planet, coming into the second house as well. We had Mercury come down here. So the second house of finances, self-esteem, value, your possessions, all of these things are lit up for you right now. So as this new moon blows through and around, I would tell you, plant your seeds of intention around your finances, passive income, how you use your creative talents to make money, any of those things. Plant your seeds of intention of what you want here. But remember, you're planting in Scorpio energy. This is deep, right? Scorpio doesn't want to hear the surface level vision of your finances. What's the deep level of your finances? Because over the next 4 weeks, Scorpio as the tour guide is going to help this play out for you. It's going to help this area come to fruition. And that means any lessons, anything that you need, any teachers, any moments that you get up and you think, oh my gosh, I can do this. It's going to help you with all of those things. So genuinely plant what is at the depth of what you would like to see happen in your second house arena. On the 21st, kind of a busy day. First, we do see Venus come into this area. And I love that because Venus is then attracting in. And she's your ruling planet. So in your money area, Venus is trying to attract in the finances, the self-esteem, the opportunity to make your money that you want. It's trying to really pull that in for you. And so as Venus is doing this over this next handful of weeks for you, work with her. Get quiet in your mind, get deep in your soul, and allow her to pull to you exactly what you are looking for, okay? Now, we also have on the 21st, the sun moving into the energy of Sagittarius, bringing light, heat, life, vitality, a sense of motivation here into your third house. But you're going to do this. You want to shine. You want to be seen. You want to have these conversations in a very Sagittarian way, which means it's up. It's beyond your fingertips. It's beyond your eyes. It's beyond your horizon. It's beyond what you've known to look at, like something greater and bigger and beyond yourself. And this Sagittarian energy, the sun here is ready to do third house things. Study, communicate, make decisions, sign those contracts, things with siblings. You know, as the sun moves into the energy of Sagittarius, you may also find that your siblings have things going on and you're needing to put your input in there. Now, I also love in the third house writing that book, writing that website, my bloggers, my journalers, boom, boom, boom. This is you. Stretch what's outside of your horizon. Are you trying to publish or market or broadcast that thing? Because Sagittarius wants to take those words and take them forward, take them on the great truth adventure. I also think at this point in the month, for you, including what we're going to see at the end of the month with the lunar eclipse, Libra, ideas of faith and ideas of your belief systems, your philosophies, your ethics, your morals, they have been pushed upon and they're asking for an acknowledgement or an adjustment here to see if they're really in alignment with where you are at this time. Now, as we get to the 29th, Neptune is going to come out of retrograde in the energy of your sixth house, and that is Pisces. Now, when Neptune is direct, we can access this space in between the worlds quite easily, and we need to be able to, because we have to be able to create in the intangible and then bring it down to something tangible. Now, when Neptune is retrograde, it is tangible, it is concrete, it is very hard typically to move between those worlds. So what we're left with is in your sixth house, you were left very concretely, very seriously looking at, does this fit my ideals? Does my daily routine fit my ideals? Does my mental health and wellness fit my ideals? The way I'm in service to other people, the way that I take care of my health, does this fit an ideal for me? And you got to really see if it did or it did not sit in alignment with that. Your day-to-day living, is that in alignment with the ideal that you would like to have? Now, as Neptune is direct, we can go back to kind of being able to access that in between the world's fantasy place that we need, because you've seen it. You've seen that it's either working or it's not working. And now this energy of, okay, let me create what's next with this so that it does align with my highest ideals. And that becomes available to you here on the 29th and going forward. Now, as we close out this month, Libra, on the 30th, we've got a full moon lunar eclipse happening in the energy of Gemini. This lights up your ninth house space, okay? Now, a full moon still, that's still the full moon for the month, and it says something needs to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted. So a very big shift is coming to this ninth house area over the next 6 months for you, okay? And this is publishing, marketing, broadcasting, putting yourself out there, the great expansion that you've got going on. And in the energy of Gemini, it's your words, it's your thinking, it's the information that you're sharing. So even if you're not a book writer, even if you're not a YouTuber, what's coming out of your mouth matters at this time. But what I think is more important about that is, like I said, when we're looking at that sun in Sagittarius and then looking at this moon here, is that truly your alignment, your life philosophy, what is it right now? What's guiding you? What are you grounding down into? What is your purpose? What is your mission statement, Libra, as you're getting up and out of bed and moving around this planet? Like, what is guiding you in that area of faith, philosophy, morals, ethics, all of that stuff? Because I think over this next 6 months, that's really what this brings a shift to. Now, of course, like I said, if you're publishing, marketing, broadcasting, any of those kinds of things, international travel, law, things that have to do with law, this energy is going to bring a shift and a change of your tides in that particular area. But it is about making sure that it's in alignment with what you're communicating. It is about words that are doing something useful out in the world, because once you say them, once you put them out there, even the way that you hold your body, the way that you're speaking, Gemini, the people you're networking with, the universe is trying to give you an alignment that is in your greatest good. Absolutely. All right, my beautiful Libra friends, I think it's going to be a good month. I think this is where we start to be able to feel the oxygen coming through the oxygen mask. And it only gets better, I think, as we move forward with all of these planets now out of that heavy retrograde time. So I look forward to seeing what you do, what you create this month. Please let me know in the comment section down below in your ideas between the beginning of the year and now, your ideas, your morals, your ethics, have your faith. Have you had a little bit of a reset? And what does that look like for you at this point, Libra? I would love to hear all about that, okay? All right, Libra, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. Have a beautiful month, and I look forward to seeing you next month. Bye, Libra.